Hello viewers, welcome to Toon'd In. I'm Josh the Fox Mills, and I review cartoons, no matter how new, no matter how old, no matter the cost. In our final week of Man Month, let's get weird! Today, I'm going to check out the Japanese absurdist comedy with the manliest anime character I've ever seen, Bobobo-Bo-Bobobo. Say that 10 times fast. What's the matter with the clothes you're wearing? Can't you tell that it's super cute? The way you're beating up all the bad guys wearing ribbons and a sailor suit. Japan has to offer unique animation. It's going to get by this fat Caucasian. Those tunes, new or old, even if it's trash or gold, it's still anime. Written and illustrated by Yoshio Sawai in 2001, Bobobo-Bo-Bobobo became its own animated series in 2003. Both the series and manga comic runs ended in 2005. The manga and show are very strange and based off of Japanese man's eye humor, which is known for puns, double talk, breaking the fourth wall, non-sexual cross-dressing for laughs, and satirical pop culture references. The theme song is really, really catchy, but explains nothing about the show, naturally. Say what? The show has enough random bits of absurdity to make your head spin. Like this.
All right. First, would you please tell us about any special qualifications that you have? Mr. Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo-Bo, let's start with you.
Right. Special skills? I got one. I do it in front of a fan. I open my mouth. I've been doing it for years. This year, I even went to state. I did well. I was first runner-up.
Signed, your biggest fan.
And this.
Tater tots! Tater tots! I want some salty, crispy tater tots!
And there was only one left and he ate it!
So that means you have to turn into a tank and blow him up?
Yeah, why not?
And this.
Ha! Jelly Jiggler says his pink lemonade is on you!
That's not what I meant!
Jelly Jiggler says to keep the pink lemonade coming your way all night long.
Please stop! Believe me, I'm so sorry. I'll have you cleaned up in no time. I'll pay for your dry cleaning bill. Now have another!
Where is everybody? The bizarre plot involved a dystopian future where the Chrome Dome Empire, led by Tsar Baldy Bald IV, would send hair hunters out to villages of the land, leaving those villages ravaged and their people shaved bald. You know, there's something I really like about this Tsar guy. Can't quite put my finger on it. Only one man could stand up to their follicle threat. A hero named Bobobo-Bo-Bobobo. The title character is, of course, Bobobo-Bo-Bobobo, or Bobobo for short. He is a tall man with Herculean muscles, a giant blonde afro and sunglasses, kind of like he walked out of 1970s America. He kind of looks like an anime Johnny Bravo. Bobobo would resist the hair hunt troop with his Fist of the Nose Hair technique, a ridiculous parody of the Fist of the North Star, an anime classic, as well as his Not For You masteries. The female main character is Beauty, and one of the only characters in the series who is actually sane. She serves as the straight man, questioning the strange things done by the rest of the cast. Also on the team is Don Patch, basically the right-hand man and rival to Bobobo, as they often attempt to one-up each other. Leader of the Wigan tribe, Don Patch is the son, Sonic the Hedgehog's head spray-painted orange? Both? Gasser fit the loner type in the group of rebel heroes. But since he was hailing from Poo Poo City, and his fist of the back wind style was quite motorous, he was probably at the request of the group. That's right. He uses farts to punch with. Finally, Jelly Jiggler was a former hare hunter, and a man made of jello, who joins our motley crew, and is constantly used as a shield by Bobobo due to his wobbliness. He serves as the comedic punching bag, as well as the actual punching bag for action sequences. There are other supporting heroes that show up as well, but it's rather infrequent, so I'll skip talking about them. Another notable character is Captain Battleship, a villain of the series and principal rival of Bobobo. His powers are similar to Bobobo, and he sports a giant black pompadour cannon. I'd get into some of the other villains, but they are vast and ever-changing, like most anime. And for good reason, as Bobobo in many ways is a parody of those kind of shows. Tragically, the show was abruptly cancelled with no finale to the main plot, which is unfortunate, but let's be honest, how could this thing have possibly ended, really? And with that, I ran out of things to talk about this strange but funny anime. Let's put my stamp on it and send it on its way.
What does the fox say?
Bobobo-Bobobo was a fine action comedy show that stayed funny till the end. If it was guilty of anything, it would be that the comedy never stopped and hit you with rapid-fire punchlines, which could burn out some viewers. It might be too stupid or spastic for the casual viewer, but it's perhaps still worth a look. Who knows? You might even like this strange little show. Well, that does it for Man Month. I'm going to calm down a bit for my next review. Watch me next time to see what I review next. Until then, viewer, I'm Josh the Fox Mills, asking you as always to stay tuned.